Hey everyone, and welcome to my YouTube channel. There's something that I never thought that I would say, and I will get back to that in a second. But before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Ishpreet and I am a transformational coach. And how I always love to quote, I help powerful people remember just how powerful they are. Well, on this channel, we are going to talk about all things related to spirituality, mental health, relationships, self-love, and all things positive, everything that's going to get your vibes way high and is going to cheer you on a bad day. That's for sure. Now, coming back to what I said earlier, why did I never think that I would be sitting here and making a YouTube video? It's precisely because of the fact that I've always had not a phobia, but I've always been running away from just making videos or just seeing myself in videos. Probably because of the fact that I have had a lot of hesitation putting myself out there and just concerned about the fact that how people are going to see my flaws and my imperfections the way that I have been seeing all my life. And I think it took me a while to just accept myself the way that I am and to embrace all of these flaws and all of these imperfections and just tell myself that no matter what, I am the only person that I have. So I'd rather treat myself with love and respect. But it was not that easy actually. It took me a while to get here. I think that I created this path for myself on my own. And the one thing that really pushed me to do that was the fact that I have always been someone who's loved going out of my comfort zones. If I had an option, if I had two options rather, an easy one or a difficult one, I've kind of always chosen the difficult one. Like now, if I see the patterns in my life, even at 21 years of age, I remember when I was pursuing my master's and I had to do an internship. I actually got selected for two of them. The first one was a very easy breezy one. It was right next to my house and I could have easily just chilled out for 2 months. Or the next option, the other option was that I had to move to a different city, manage my accommodation on my own, food on my own, and the city was boiling. It was boiling at 47 degrees at the time. And it was a very sales intensive sort of a job. And it involved actually just field work and going out in the market the entire day behind a salesperson on a two-wheeler. Not something that the girls in my college are very fond of, so they all backed out and I was left with a bunch of guys. Not even a bunch of guys, actually, even the guys backed out, only 3 or 4 guys. And I had the decision to make that if I wanted to go with them or I wanted to take this easy route. And I obviously chose the second one, which was moving to a different city. And I cannot begin to tell you the kind of learnings that I had. It was phenomenal. The things that I learned living on my own, living with an unknown family, and just making these relationships or making these bonds with people along the way. It was really, really something that I still cherish. And the fact that I'm talking about it still just makes it count. So the same thing I applied for my phobia. Okay, let's not call it phobia. For my hesitation of making videos. So 3 months ago, when the lockdown actually happened, I told myself that I did not want to get out of the lockdown the same person. So I made a decision to make these random live videos on Facebook. And again, that was not a very easy decision to make, because the first time that I had the phone in my hand, I was just staring at the screen for 20 minutes, not knowing what to do with it and what am I going to say and how are people going to perceive, what are they going to perceive of me as, and just these random foolish thoughts coming in my mind. And then after a point, I told myself that it is what it is. Let's go for it. We'll see, whatever happens, happens. So I pressed the button and never looked back. I kept making these videos no matter how anxious I was, how nervous I was. The first few videos were a challenge. I mean, it didn't look like a challenge if you go back on my Facebook profile and actually see them. But inside of me, there was a part of me that was a little nervous. But over the period of these 3 months, I sort of saw this enormous change in me, enormous sense of confidence in me. And just the way that I presented myself had, like, it really made a difference. It really made a difference in the way that I was and the way that I carried myself. And I think that is a very, that is the main reason why I'm sitting here, because I also realized that in those months, the number of messages that I got, the number of people reaching out to me, telling me how those videos made a difference to them and how it impacted them and how it was the first thing that they actually saw in the morning, first thing. And it just made my heart so happy. And I just knew that I had to reach out to a much larger audience no matter what. So that's what I decided to do. And that's how this YouTube channel is now being started. And the main intention is that all the following videos that I'm gonna bring up here, we all can hopefully learn together, grow together, and take inspiration from each other and make it a journey worthwhile. So yeah, that's it. And I think the one thing that I would want you to take away from this video is that find that one thing that you've been holding on to for a long time and you've not been doing it, something that you were always scared to do, or you just didn't believe in yourself enough for it to do. So take that first step. You don't have to figure out everything at once. Take this as a sign. Take this video as a sign. I am big on signs. For me, I feel everything is a sign. Mostly everything. Not in a lunatic sort of a way, but still. Yeah, so take this as a sign and just start taking those baby steps towards something that you're actually passionate about doing or something that you would love to do, but a part of you is super scared. So make that first step. You don't want to regret it at the end of your life. You don't want to think and just ponder over the fact that what if I would have taken that one step. So yeah, that's about it. And leave something nice in the comment section below. Something just positive about your life, or something that if this video has inspired you to do something, and I would love to hear that from you. And there are a lot more videos for me to come. So let's wait for that. And for now, that's all. I'm gonna see you in my next video. Bye.